Welcome back to T. Frank's Film Room. It's been a while since we've been in here. Don't worry, we've made a couple of upgrades. Furniture's still uncomfortable, but we have some new equipment that we're working with. But it's the same old film analysis that you're used to for Penn State football commits. And today we're talking about class of 2023 four-star cornerback Lamont Payne out of Chartiers Valley in the Pittsburgh area. He is the next recruit in Penn State secondary and the second in the class of 2023. So what makes Lamont Payne a priority target for Penn State football? That's what we're going to get into today. Don't forget, if you're watching T. Frank's Film Room on YouTube, subscribe to our YouTube page so you don't miss anything that we got going on, including the Daily Edition, our live post-game shows after Penn State football games, and our Monday recap shows where we break down the game after we've had some time to digest it while we're digesting our lunch. That's on Mondays. But right now we're getting into Lamont Payne, the four-star corner. He is a really good physical specimen, 6 foot tall, 165 pounds, about 31-ish inch arms, but he plays much bigger than that. And that, to me, is the hallmark of what Lamont Payne is. He's another one of those guys that is more than the sum of his parts. But when it comes to his physical abilities, we'll get to that at the end. They are not, by any means, anything to sneeze at. As the 228th player in the nation, he is the 8th player in the state of Pennsylvania. He's a good football player. But what makes him special to me? That is what we're going to start with. And I would say when you start with Lamont Payne, you start with his ability to just find the football. Now, some of these are arm punts from quarterbacks, and some of them are legitimately great plays on the ball, but either way, he finds the ball. That's what Lamont Payne does. You can see over multiple different times where he's tracking the quarterback's eyes, coming off his assignment, and getting to the football. Again, that's not a great throw right there, but the ability to make a play and get into position off of his man. Here, you see him do it again. He can track the ball and make plays. And here's one where it's just a random, really good play. Like, that's not a traditional play that you normally get out of a cornerback to just be able to put his hand up in the air and get his hands on the football. That is the hallmark of what Lamont Payne does, is he can break up passes. He finds the receiver. He gets targets. He has good instincts in that situation. And in Penn State's zone-heavy schemes, that's something that's really important. Instincts of knowing when to go and break on the football, finding the receiver, watching the patterns, and knowing what's going on. You can see how smart he is just by watching the film, and he's aware of certain things that most guys who are just trying to follow their man or, you know, make sure their fundamentals are correct and backpedal properly, he's got all that stuff down. He is staring into the quarterback's eyes and finding where the ball is going. Now, at the next level, he has to be careful because the quarterback is going to know that you're doing that. So if, you know, he's going to have to make sure he maintains that level of football intelligence, the higher the level he goes to. But the good news is he's not just an off-cover corner. He has man coverage skills as well. And this is really exciting stuff to watch what he does at the line of scrimmage. As you can see here, he's bench pressing a receiver, but he doesn't let up after that. And those abilities to get to the football, he has really good hands at just poking the ball away, just at the last second, getting his hand in and poking the ball out and then making it an incompletion. This has been a priority for Penn State football's finding guys that can do this, that sort of zone coverage that turns into man, or if you want to play straight up and play in a guy's face, he can do that as well. As you see here, he's got the ability at the line of scrimmage, the jam, the physicality, the long arms, the tenacity, it's all there. I love this trick too, by the way. And you see here where he's blocking, the same physicality shows up. So it's not just on one side of the ball or the other. It's in his DNA. This right here is my favorite trick of, if he's an ineligible receiver, I don't have to cover him any longer. So you've got the mentality there. And you can see, as this is some of his junior film, as he's matured, that physicality is not just for the physicality's sake. He's using that and looking back at the quarterback to see if he's disrupted the pass, to see if the ball is coming, to be more aware of what's going on around him. So I love a lot of what he brings to the table from a coverage aspect. That is a big thing that he can play at three levels of the field. He can play in deep zone coverage. He can play in that middle area, and he can play straight up, nose to nose with players at the line of scrimmage. So that's a really good skill set to be working with. Those are all the intangible football intelligence, learn the position, play football well sort of things. I really like that that's what he brings to the table. And that's why he was a priority get for Penn State football and why they've been after him and they've been making him a priority in-state player this early in 2023. I think it's a good fit for what Penn State has been doing. They, at first, you look at some of his skills and you say, okay, especially what's on tape first, a lot of man coverage skills. But the more you dig into it and the more you see, the versatility is there. And the versatility, not just to do that, but to also play and to play physically at multiple levels of the field. His tackling is really good. So when you're playing in zone coverage, you're not always going to make plays on the ball. It's not always going to be your decision whether or not the guy catches the ball. You have to rally and tackle. That's the other half of zone coverage, where if the guy catches it, they can't get extra yards or else you've defeated the point of letting them catch the ball and then tackling them for a short gain. You can see he is, the physicality is not just at, you know, during the route, it's afterwards as well. I'd say he's a good tackler. I wouldn't put him in the category of some of the guys that we've seen recently, like Jordan Allen, or even some of the guys that Penn State has on their roster right now, but he's good at this. This is something that I think he is brings to the table, that physicality above his 165 pounds. It's all good stuff. It's all good stuff on his tape. The last part is, you know, I'm just going to roll this because I want us all to watch this together. I don't really know what to do when it comes to his athleticism because he's not the same guy on tape as he is this year as he was last year. And this is last year. I think you can say he's a long strider. He's got good athleticism, but this is from this year. And he's clearly dealing with an injury. So how athletic is he? How fast is he? I'm struggling to really get a good read on that, and I don't want to be unfair because he is gutting through something. You can see just in general the same pop, the same guy on tape really isn't there. One thing I do think we can see, as you see here, he does have good hips. He can turn and run with any receiver. He can flip his hips, and he can run at the drop of a hat. Now, if you're flipping your hips that many times, as you saw in the first one, you're probably going to be beat. But you see here, again, on his junior film, some of his technique is more refined. He is more aware of what he's doing, and it's all with more of a purpose. But the athleticism part, that's the part when it's the, what's the upper end of his skills? Now that he's a junior and he's developed, I don't really know because you, through the first five games of the season, I don't want to be unfair and give him lower marks for being injured. When, you know, he has a documented 4.68 that we've seen, I'd say he's a little faster than that, but that is an area where I do think he is going to have to improve over time. But at 6'1", 165, puts more muscle on, adds a little more explosion into his profile. He will get faster, but I don't think that speed is ever going to be a part of his long-term profile. He's going to win with his physicality, his intelligence, and his positional skills, which right now are advanced. And all of those things, if you start chasing speed and you just look for speed, you'll miss guys like Lamont Payne that are genuinely great at football. So I think that that's something to keep in mind because if you miss on those guys, those are sometimes guys that can change games with their intelligence, their ability to get plays on the ball. So Lamont Payne, to me, I think is a great prospect. It is going to be interesting to see throughout the rest of the year if whatever is that lower body injury, whatever he's dealing with, if that heals up, does he show a little bit more explosion, a little more speed? Because if he can pair all of that together, I think he's a prime candidate to be a boundary receiver, the guy who's going up against the other big physical player for the offense, you know, on the short side of the field where he's working in a smaller space, but he can use the sideline and he can use his long arms and his physicality and violence to control some of the more physical receivers in the Big Ten. I think that's a great spot for him. Now, long term, and I should say, I don't think this is the best path for him because his coverage skills are too diverse to put in a certain situation. But Penn State has shown that even good athletes like Keaton Ellis, who I thought was a very good athlete at corner, they're not afraid to move them to that field safety position, which is that free safety, slot player playing in, you know, zone coverage, but has some more versatility responsibilities over top of receivers where you find yourself one-on-one at times, even in zone coverage. That is a future possibility for Lamont Payne, but I don't think it's the most likely one. But you just can't ignore his ability to break on the ball and to hit people and his desire for contact. But the first place you're going to start with Lamont Payne is that I think that boundary corner where he can be physical and he can use his diverse skill set to be a borderline lockdown corner with those skills. The question is going to become, I think he's a good athlete on film, even in some of his earlier tape when he's not injured. I just don't know how great of an athlete that upper end is. But guys develop at different rates, different paces, and he's got plenty of room to grow into that frame. So Lamont Payne is the next player in the class of 2023 for Penn State football. I'm Thomas Frank Carr. This has been T. Frank's Film Room. Do not forget, hit subscribe, and we'll be back again for the next Penn State football commit.